Okay, so today we have Matthias talking a little bit about pathing in our game. And if I see this correctly, this is already the visualization of a flight path. Of
it's just the spline that this ship is flying on. I'm just rendering it for debugging purposes. Of course, you will not see that in the game. The big ships and many of our smaller ships use a pre-calculated path, so we don't do many iterative calculations to save on performance, basically. And some of these paths also can look a bit better and smoother than doing like calculations per frame if you don't do it.
Definitely, compared to what we had in the past, people probably don't realize it, but this iterative steering was the only steering all the X games had in the past, which means they basically decide in every frame, they decide again how to turn. They don't look ahead in the future.
Okay, what we can see pretty well here is we had a ship starting out at a position somewhere down here. I don't know, it's near the station. And we just, the script basically just gave the pathing system a target point at the far end of the station and even slightly inside the bounding box of the station, which is a challenge for the ship. Our system then, on a so-called job thread, which is not stalling the game while it's calculating, just evaluates certain paths and, if needed, adds intermediate points at certain positions so that the spline does not intersect with the station geometry itself. Mm-hmm. So, like we see here, it takes a pretty well-rounded and safe path to a point on the far end of the station where it currently wants to sell some energy cells.
Uh-huh. So this is a trader ship?
This is an energy trader, yes.
Uh-huh. Ah, and the little symbol there, that's energy offer. So
right, down here.
Mm-hmm. So this ship is flying close to this energy trade location and starts unloading there? Or?
Yes.
Is this yellow dot there a marker?
This is the debug rendering where the ship wants to end up. Okay, let me just make it a bit faster.
Ah, now you are accelerating time.
Yeah.
Well, but this is not the game feature. We have to point that out. This is not possible in normal game.
Now it's just strafing a bit closer, mm-hmm. so that the small ships don't have to fly as far. And let me fly it closer now. See, now we're at a point where it's pretty much guaranteed that we don't have to do any path calculation for these smaller ships. Mm-hmm. It's guaranteed that this is a free path, so we don't have to use performance for that.
So what we see here is the unloading traffic for the energy cells.
You see the filled cargo ships fly from our capital ship into the station, mm-hmm. and out come a few empty ones. Mm-hmm. They have energy cells on board when they fly there and don't have them when they come back. If the station had transport units of its own, it would have sent the empty ones out immediately and mm-hmm. they would have come back filled. So they should be running at peak efficiency if possible.
When you said before these calculations are done on a script, and you said it's done in parallel. Does it also mean it runs on a separate thread if you have multi-threading available?
Yes. If you have more than two cores, basically, which mm-hmm. Almost everybody has nowadays.
Yeah.
Let's not say two cores. Let's say two threads, because there's hyper-threading as well. Then every processor that is not used by other game system is then freed up for this job engine, which...
Ah, now we are seeing unintentionally another cool feature of
that
the game.
Not
we
planned.
The player is now basically...
I'm in the, we sometimes call it gravity well of the ship.
Yes.
It's It's mostly a gameplay convenience for when you do want to do fights close to a
It's important, especially for larger ships. I mean, it surprises me that this relatively small trader ship also already has this feature, but it's very essential when you try to attack large capital ships.
Yeah.
Very cool. Ah, now we see a new path, so it's
it's
landing.
Fly somewhere else. Mm-hmm. Looks okay. Right, where were we before? threads, right.
Yes, multi-threading.
Yes, like if you say you have a computer from the future and have like 32 cores, then the game would create probably like around 28 or so drop threads.
X Rebirth is optimized for computers from the future. Hopefully not just.
Hopefully you don't need one, but like many things will scale well.
Yeah.
It's not only the pathing calculations that would benefit from that, but mostly like loading of things and uncompressing the loaded data like meshes and textures into memory. That is also done on these drop threads. So the more cores you have, theoretically, the faster you will see stuff appear on screen.
I think that's one of the things we will talk about in another video, is the asynchronous loading, which is helping everywhere, but it's a different topic.
Okay, that was a capital ship flying to a position, which is basically just avoiding like the big shape of the station. It's not actually able to like maneuver through tight spots.
It wouldn't make sense for such a large ship, but definitely it's important to, it's worth noticing, because this wasn't possible at all in the past.
Yeah.
Capital ships would, in all of the X games in the past, the capital ship would just fly a huge circle around the station just to avoid it. And especially now with the new stations, the geometry is getting even more complex, much more complex actually.
Right.
So a capital ship would easily get stuck and infinitely try to steer its way out of that geometry.
Mm.